Welcome all, Papa G here. Today I present my beef braciole. This Italian classic has been around for a long time and has quite a few different varieties of recipes and techniques. Well, today I'm going to show you mine. Let's get started. We'll begin making our filling by adding some whole milk ricotta cheese to a mixing bowl, along with some shredded mozzarella cheese, shredded parmesan cheese, some dried basil, just a little salt, ground black pepper, one slightly beaten egg, and what Italian recipe isn't complete without garlic? With the help of this garlic press, we'll be mincing 5 large cloves. Give this a mix to thoroughly combine. Most braciole recipes have a drier filling. Some may include some breadcrumbs and other things like that. This recipe is inspired by my mom's filling. She used a wonderful vinegar and onion base sauce, but we'll be using more of a traditional tomato base for our sauce. Once mixed together, set aside. We'll be utilizing some red wine in our sauce recipe. I'll be using this Cabernet for mine, but any will do as long as it doesn't have any added sugar and is drinkable. You'll need about a half a cup. Remember to pour yourself a glass when you're measuring out. Oh, the benefits of being the cook. Cheers. Also, before we start with the beef portion of the recipe, it's helpful to have some butcher's twine pre-cut. About 12 to 14 inches should work fine. For our beef, we'll be using 2 pounds of round steak, flattened to about a quarter inch in thickness. We're not tenderizing here, just flattening. The cooking technique we're going to use will have the toughest cuts of meat for it tender. For a more consistent texture, I like to trim off any areas of excess fat. Section by cutting in half and cutting the halves in half. We'll have 8 pieces total. I like to position the butcher's twine before filling the meat. It just makes things a little easier as you progress. Use 1 piece of twine per roll. Lay the beef over the twine so that the longer side runs along the twine. Add some salt and ground black pepper. Now flip so the seasoned side is down. We're only going to season the outside of the beef. Our filling will season the inside of the beef quite well. To help with portioning, section the filling in half and portion a quarter of the half for each piece. Spread the filling over the meat. Add 1 thin slice of prosciutto over the top. If you don't have a meat shop around you, you shouldn't have any trouble finding it prepackaged at your local grocer. Roll the beef away from you. Notice I'm using my fingers to sort of tuck the prosciutto in as I roll. Tie the beef in the middle. You don't have to be fancy with a knot, just be sure it's tight and snug. Repeat until all the beef is filled and rolled. Use a knife or kitchen scissors to trim the excess string. Add 4 tablespoons of oil to a large Dutch oven on medium-high heat. Be sure the oil is evenly distributed along the bottom. When the oil comes up to temperature, add the beef rolls. Let this cook undisturbed for 3 to 4 minutes. Flip and sear the other side for another 3 to 4 minutes. Some may stick just a bit. Just be careful so as to not to pull apart the roll. Remove the rolls to a plate, as now we'll construct our sauce. Add one medium diced onion to the pan and stir. Cook until the onions have softened a bit. Add 2 tablespoons of tomato paste and stir in. You'll want to cook the tomato paste for about a minute or so to help enrich the flavor and also darken the color. Now stir in 1/2 cup of red wine. Cook this and stir for at least a minute so as to burn out all the alcohol. Remember, with every liquid ingredient we add, to gently scrape the bottom of the pan. That fond is flavor waiting to be released. Add 1 15-ounce can of crushed tomatoes and give a stir. Now add our final liquid. Stir in 2 1/2 cups of beef stock. Remember to gently scrape the bottom as you stir. For our seasonings, we'll add some salt, ground black pepper, Italian seasoning, red pepper flakes, some dried oregano, garlic powder, and to help balance the acidity of the tomatoes, a 0-carb sugar substitute equal to 2 teaspoons of regular sugar. Finally, some dried basil. Give a mix to combine. When it comes to a simmer, turn off the heat and add the beef back to the pot. Be sure to add any accumulated liquid from the beef to the pot. Cover in place in the middle of a preheated 325-degree oven for 2 hours. Halfway through the cooking, flip the rolls to help cook evenly. Now, some of you may have noticed these ominous-looking paws. That's our Doberman Zeke. He may be of German heritage, but he can smell Italian food 10 miles away. After 2 hours, remove the beef from the sauce. We'll finish the sauce by adding in 1 tablespoon of dried parsley. Gently snip and remove the string from the beef. Serve hot. Ladle over some of that luxurious sauce. And I personally like to top mine with a little extra parmesan. Garnish with a little dried parsley. Now, I'm not sure why I'm using a knife here. This beef is fork tender. Delicious. There you have it, folks, my beef braciole recipe, a tender and delicious Italian classic. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like and consider subscribing. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.